This is Chinese Pod, and my name is Ken Carroll.
Hi, I'm Jenny.
Jenny, what are we talking about today?
We are in a state of ambiguity.
State of ambiguity.
Yes, okay. We're talking about, is a person man or woman?
Okay.
That can be hard to figure out.
You mean you see somebody in a public sphere, space,
and
you don't know if it's a boy or a girl. Okay.
The mannerisms and the way he or she dresses might indicate both.
Okay.
Or either way. Sorry.
All right. So it could be, I don't know, you're just people watching, or it could be in a restaurant and you don't know whether to call a guy or a girl. Okay. All right. Is that a man or a woman over there? That's the kind of thing. All right. So let's listen to this dialogue 3 times and then we will hopefully figure it out.
Identify. 对话第一遍。
那个人是男的还是女的?
肯定是男的,头发那么短。
但是走路的样子像女的。
是有点像,不过长得像男的。
到底是男的还是女的?
我也糊涂了。第二遍。
那个人是男的还是女的?
肯定是男的,头发那么短。
但是走路的样子像女的。
是有点像,不过长得像男的。
到底是男的还是女的?
我也糊涂了。第三遍。
那个人是男的还是女的?
肯定是男的,头发那么短。
但是走路的样子像女的。
是有点像,不过长得像男的。
到底是男的还是女的?
我也糊涂了。
Let's translate it.
Sure. 那个人是男的? 还是女的?
Is that a boy or a girl?
那个人是男的还是女的?
Is that a male or female?
那个人是男的还是女的? 肯定是男的,头发那么短。
I think for sure it's a male, the hair is so short.
肯定是男的,头发那么短。
It's got to be a male. The hair is so short.
肯定是男的,头发那么短。但是走路的样子像女的。But
the way she walks looks kind of female.
但是走路的样子像女的。But
the gait looks kind of female.
但是走路的样子像女的。 是有点像,不过长得像男的。Yeah,
looks a little bit like that, but he looks male.
是有点像,不过长得像男的。Yes,
it does, but he looks male.
是有点像,不过长得像男的。到底是男的还是女的?
So is it a boy or a girl?
到底是男的还是女的?
So is it a boy or a girl?
到底是男的还是女的? 我也糊涂了。I'm
kind of confused too.
我也糊涂了。I'm
confused too.
我也糊涂了。
Okay,
Well, that posed a lot of questions when you translate it.
It does when you translate this stuff.
Weirdly, because Chinese often avoids mentioning the subject, so you can have flowing conversation.
That's right.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of sentences here that didn't actually use pronouns.
No.
Whereas in English, you'd kind of have to. So it's kind of odd, but it's interesting.
Yeah.
So we can look at that too. Now, let's look at that first sentence.
Mm. 那个人是男的还是女的?
Now, 那个人 meaning that person.
Yes.
Now, is 男的 meaning...
Male.
Male. 还是...
女的。
女的, female.
Yes.
So, it's just 男的,女的, meaning male with the da indicates an adjective, right?Belonging to, in a sense, Nanda.
Yes.
Is that of the male of the species or the female of the species? Nanda, Nuda, Nanda, Haishin, Nuda. All right. Now your interlocutor is fairly sure at this point. It's got to be male.
肯定是男的。肯定是男的。
那肯定 is a very useful phrase, very high frequency, meaning for sure. 肯定. Also, 一定 is also quite common too, right? But 肯定是男的. Oh, for sure, that's a male. It's a guy.
Mm.
Now, the next sentence is an example of where we don't have a pronoun here.
头发那么短. 头发那么短.
头发那么短. Now, 头发 meaning hair, of course. Now, this expression, 那么 is really useful.
Yep.
Tell us something about it.
那么 indicates...emphasis.
Emphasis.
It means so,
so
or
short,
such.
Or that short.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we can use it in other ways too.
For example, 那么高 or 你的中文那么好。
哦，中文那么好。Your Chinese is so good.
对，你长得那么漂亮。
Okay. So again, so the expression here was the hair is so short.
头发那么短
Now, so it's just literally hair so short.
Yes.
So when in English, you'd need a pronoun. You'd have to say his hair or her hair or that person's hair. Okay.
Yes.
Now, but here we have it again in the next sentence. So let's hear that again. The idea that you don't actually need a pronoun.
但是走路的样子像女的。但是走路的样子像女的。
Now, 但是 but, 走路 meaning
to walk.
Walk. Now, 走路的样子 meaning the 样子 means
the appearance, the look,
the way.
The way,
Yes, yeah. So, 走路的样子 means the person's gait, the way they walk, the way they go. 走路的样子 is really, really helpful little phrase there. 走路的样子. It could be like if somebody was ill or had a problem or was drunk or something, you could say 走路的样子, and then you could describe it. Now, in this case, looks female.
走路的样子像女的，像女的。
那像 fourth tone, right? Meaning to appear to be, to look like.
Yes.
Right.
That
is a really, really kind of lexically rich sentence there. Let's listen to it again if we could.
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Chinese Pod Trivia.Our first question is, how long will it take you to become an intermediate Chinese speaker using the Chinese Pod app? Is it A, the rest of your life? B, you should already be an intermediate speaker? C, 3 months? Or D, Chinese Pod has an app?
You should already be in...
Ooh, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, 3 months. That's right. Head over to ChinesePod.com now to register for your access to over 4,000 lessons.Get the Chinese Pod app now on Google Play or the App Store.
但是走路的样子像女的。
Great. Now, 走路的样子, we could actually change that around, couldn't we? You could use other verbs there. Instead of 走路, what else could you say?
吃饭的样子。
The way that person eats, right? Not good.
然后说话的样子。
The speaking, the way of speaking. All right, good. 像 whatever, 女的男的还是 you could choose different countries or something there.
Yeah.
Really useful stuff. Now, yes, it is, it does appear that way, somewhat.
是有点像。是有点像。
Good. 是 meaning yes, 有一点, a little bit. 像, that's the verb again, to appear, to be like, to be similar.
Yes.
是有一点像. Now that's a really common kind of phrase, 有一点像.
You know, or you can omit, just say 有点像, like we had in the dialogue.
Yes.
有点像.
有点像, 对. Now, but that person looks...
Reverse back.
Yeah, yeah.
不过长得像男的
Now 长得像长 third tone
长
meaning, 长、third tone meaning
To grow
literally、But this expression 长得像 meaning
Looks like、
In the sense of it, this has grown to look this way Has grown、this way Appears、to be Now 不过 meaning however
Yes
That's a great expression So let's hear that sentence again, the full sentence.
是有点像,不过长得像男的。
Great. Now, 长得像男的, but looks like, maybe walks like a woman, but looks like a man. There you go.
So after a few rounds back and forth, they still haven't pinned it down.
And so that this kind of like, wow, we still don't know. There's a great expression here, and that is.
到底是男的还是女的?到底是男的还是女的?
So, 到底。Now, 到底 is a great expression.
Yeah.
And it means, you know...
Exactly, precisely.
Exactly. Yeah. Or ultimately in that sense, too.
Yes,
in that sense.
Ultimately.
Ultimately. So, in other words, you might have it... Use it after you've had some lengthy discussion and you still can't decide it.
Yes.
So it's ultimately like, what? So in the end, finally, that kind of a feeling too, it can be used. So the question here was,
到底是男的还是女的?
Right, so the way I would translate that is, so is it a boy or a girl?
Yeah.
So finally, ultimately, what is the call here? Make a call here. Now here's another good expression. Well, I'm confused too.
我也糊涂了。我也糊涂了。
我也糊涂了。糊涂 is a very, very useful expression.
Yes.
Meaning, tell us more about it.
It means puzzled, confused.
Confused, kind of murky.
Yeah, not clear.
But it only refers to thinking, right? You wouldn't say you'd have like, you know...
Visually murky, no, it's not 糊涂。
Okay, good. It's something in terms of thinking.
Yes.
Okay.
State of mind.
State of mind. Can somebody be permanently kind of 糊涂?
Yeah, it's a personality.
Ah.
Like forgetful, not always very clear.
All right. Well, now, in this case, it's referring to a very specific issue. But it can also be used to refer to a kind of a person who is slightly, what
would you call it? I'd say 糊涂 as a personality means forgetful.
Forgetful. Okay. Absent-minded maybe.
Yeah,
not
absent-minded.
Not particularly clear. That's interesting. Okay. Let's listen to that three times.
对话第一遍。
那个人是男的还是女的？
肯定是男的，头发那么短。
但是走路的样子像女的。
是有点像，不过长得像男的。
到底是男的还是女的？
我也糊涂了。
第二遍。
那个人是男的还是女的？
肯定是男的，头发那么短。
但是走路的样子像女的。
是有点像，不过长得像男的。
到底是男的还是女的？
我也糊涂了。
第三遍。
那个人是男的还是女的？
肯定是男的，头发那么短。
但是走路的样子像女的。
是有点像，不过长得像男的。
到底是男的还是女的？
我也糊涂了。
Okay, now lots of stuff inside. All of this, we try to put it into context for you.
对。
So you can imagine a scenario where you might use it, where you can actually hear it being used, of course, and in the follow-up would be to go to ChinesePod.com and to actually see the words, explore them in a lot more detail, because that's how the real learning happens. And one of the things I think that inevitably happens is when you go there, you see links between these words and other words, between these phrases and other phrases, and that's the type of association that helps you to build and retain the language. However...
It's time to say 再见.
再见.
ChinesePod.com. Your time, your place, your pace. Mandarin on your terms. ChinesePod.com.
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.ChinesePod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number
0627.
So just go to www.ChinesePod.com/0627 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.ChinesePod.com/0627.